one big clap for me. Two claps. Three big claps. Done.
Yo, welcome to The Creative Agent. No excuses with our next guest. He is one of the genuine good guy hustlers of the industry. Always a badass, always a gentleman, Mr. Eddy Piddington. Let's get into it. Okay, awesome, Eddy. Thanks for coming, man.
Thanks, Clay. Good to see
you. Yeah, you too. I'm super excited. First of all, like, I've been seeing that you're crushing it over there.
Thanks,
on
man.
The beaches.
Trying, yep.
It seems to me like one of these places, Manly and those northern beaches of Sydney, that are super competitive and quite saturated with sort of other agents and agencies in there, yep. Long established ones. How do you find, I guess, the, because I want to get straight into it.
Yep.
How do we find like the best way to sort of stand out in that space?
So as an agent point of view, so are you thinking someone that's just starting in the industry or?
Kind of both, like is it something that someone starting can make an impact on that market? Or do you think it is a long game and they've got to come in and get those kind of small wins and build up that small
Yeah, game? I think it's definitely a long game. Like there is, from the outside looking in, a lot of people want to be an agent. I think you start in 6 months, next thing you've got good cars and all these bits and pieces. So yeah, I've done it for 16 years now and it's taken time, man. It's taken time and it's still really hard. Like it's a big hustle day in and day out. You're right, it's super competitive, but there's about 72 agents in Manly and our like core suburbs around that. So it's super competitive. How do you stand out? Like I think it's really basics. It's like being a real person. It's always mentally to be a person first and a real estate agent second.
Yeah.
I think people are not over it, but a lot of agents out there, like, I mean, you're even on Instagram, like everything's about property and it's so boring a bit to me, you know? Yeah. Like, so I think people want to have someone they can relate to, be real with, not be intimidated by. Mm-hmm. Some of the agents think it's being an agent is like, on another level to everyone else.
Totally.
So it's a hard question, man. I don't actually know how to answer it. Doing the right thing by people, yeah. I think it's really important as well.
Yeah.
Standing out, to be a newcomer and to try and stand out in this market, I think would be almost impossible.
Wow.
Without being negative, like, yeah. You're right, it's super competitive. There's not five good agents in our area, there's probably 10 super agents, like really yeah. good agents. All my competitors I come up against are really good guys, they're all really good agents, they all know what they're doing. So it's hard, like even why us or why them, you know? Yeah. For someone to come in that's got 6 months experience, have never worked in this kind of climate before, I don't know how they cut through.
Yep. Because it kind of seems to me too, like I look at the guys that are crushing it, our clients that are doing the listings, it almost seems like it's actually not a result of anything they're really doing now. I'm sure you yeah. guys are busting your ass, but it's like, it seems like all the work they did 6 months, 12 months, 2 years ago.
Yeah.
Like it yes. seems very relationship-based, right, at the moment?
100% relationship-based. We know now like the meetings and the phone calls we'll do today will show up in 3 months. You mm-hmm. know, so there's that hustle that you've got to just keep going and knowing that it's going to come in the future. And you're right, I think like we are hustling really hard and we do hustle hard. And the track record, I think as you come into a market that's up and down, if I was selling my house or my car or anything that's of value, want to be going with the guys that with some runs on the board.
Okay.
Not X, Y, and Z, because he's a nice guy, he's a bit cheaper.
Yeah.
You might pull that off in a really good market, but at the moment it's about security. He sold four, they're all similar to mine. I feel more comfortable, you know?
So how are you getting that information out? Like in terms of that social proof and the results?
So is in socially, like social media,
yeah,
right?
So, or just like, yeah, it could be word of mouth, printing. Like is part of your marketing strategy, I guess, or your listing presentations, are you more focusing on the results then?
Yeah, I think results are super key, track record's key, experience in the marketplace, and then just like knowledge and skill. Like know our stuff, right? And we need to know our stuff to pull yeah. off these deals. How do you get these over? It's probably just in the meetings. Like fortunately, after a while, I think in real estate, there's two businesses, and one's like an attraction business, where more clients are coming to us, like mm-hmm. your business and setup. And then the other business is kind of the hustle and they're both hustle, but more of a chasing mentality. Yeah. We're chasing good business. There's a lot of agents out there just chasing anything under the sun to try and make money, which is fair enough, but it's about chasing the right business. And then once we get them, they're almost coming to us and then explaining why we are different and maybe better than some of the competitors,
yeah.
Which is hard because everyone's really good.
Sure. What's a right business look for you?
Like, oh, I think it's just the right vendor. So we're still getting right now in our marketplace, someone, you'll get it, they'll come in and say, Eddy, we don't have to sell, unless we get $2 million, we're not selling it. We only want to do it off mark. We don't want to pay for any of this marketing stuff. And, you know, we kind of want it sold tomorrow afternoon by 3 o'clock. It's like, well, I want a Ferrari too, and I ain't fucking getting one this year. So there's a bit of that in the moment, Clay. So I think it's mostly that motivation. It's like, so why are you selling? Where are you going? We've bought it. We want to upsize. Some of them will sell. We know the market hasn't changed with COVID because this area is this and my property is that, which is fine, but it's a bit of a balance. You know, like, and I think the market's changed a little bit. It's not significant, but it has changed.
Yeah.
And it's all relative, because if the market's come back 5%, whatever you buy is coming back 5%. So I think it's a great market for people to be upsizing. If they're in this mentality of no, it's like a tick box. Yeah. No, and we're not paying the right fee. We only want to pay you this. It's like, well,
it's like a real scarcity kind of mindset.
Yeah.
So I guess you'd have to be really self-aware of where your time and energy is being placed 100%. Now. Well.
That's a great question. So I reckon, right now, every deal we're doing, to get top dollar, anyone can sell anything right now, but it's about how we get a record, a maximum result. One we just sold last week, lady bought in the absolute peak of the market,
yeah,
hoping to get her money back, sold it in 9 days for like 270 grand more than she paid. It's like a life changer, right? She's over the moon. Shouldn't happen when she's bought at the peak and it's adjusted a bit, but coming back to do those deals, it's taking like 3-4 times the amount of time and energy. You know what I mean? So you're absolutely spot on, man. I think at the moment we're better to have 5 good listings and good sellers versus 10 and 5 of them are headaches. We haven't seen our team, like, one really bad seller can wreck the other 5 good ones. You're taking all my time, you're not even gonna sell it. It's negative, it's draining, and then my other good clients aren't getting the service and the results they require. So yeah, it is, it's really, it's funny, it's about, like, if I'm going to go come and sell your house, you're interviewing me, but at the same time, we're interviewing you a bit.
Yeah.
You know, I think at the moment it's important.
Yeah. So then I guess, this question, I guess, would be, coming up 3 years at Stone now?
Yes. Yeah. Yeah.
I think it was like,
you know, more than me. Yeah. I think it's 3 years, man. Yeah. Spot on. Yeah.
Yeah, man, I remember the announcements and doing all the cool.
Great. Yeah. We did it together, of course. Yeah. Good fun.
Have you kind of seen that evolve? Like, I feel like, you know, at the time when you entered Stone, it was really the digital focused. I kind of feel like a lot of brands are kind of catching up a little bit in that respect of having a digital database and
yes,
a network and things like that. How have you seen, sort of technology-wise or digitally, the market change or kind of catch up in those years?
So, look, it's a good call. Like, so yeah, we're still heavily digital based, you know, not a lot of paper advertising. We can't now anyway because paper's gone, but even historically when I started there, it wasn't a major focus for us, whereas we feel the world is evolving to apps on our phones and obviously online and things like that. How do I see it adapting? It's really interesting, the deals we're doing, I think, and like working with buyers, advertising, it's almost going back to basics.
Yeah.
So some of the clients I'm working with and sellers and that, we talk about strategy and that, and the strategy is quite simple. I think some agents that haven't been around as long and don't get it are really complicating it and
too flashy.
Totally do. Trying to be too flash, trying to be games and almost too strategic, and buyers are just like, well, that's weird, just leave it.
Yeah.
You know, so a lot of things like even advertising properties with prices versus not, it's a major question, like, and a lot of agents will do it when it's overpriced, try and hide the price, versus us, like, we'll just launch it back to basics, put the price on it, be clear with the buyers. If we get 4 people through, we know it straight away it's off track and not in line with the market. We get 26 groups through, on track, we're fine, we can continue. Versus I think a lot of agents trying to save the vendor and things. So coming back to your question, it's more about simplicity, not getting too digital and out there to a degree.
Yeah, it's amazing how those fundamentals can really act like, I guess, tracks when shit starts going a bit crazy, right?
Yes.
And go like, bang.
Yeah, and people look for opportunities. Like, yeah. I can't think of what it is right now, but someone will come out with a new product that everyone needs because you're going to get more money from the buyer. And it's well, really, it's simplicity. If they're not on realestate.com, they're not buying, right? Or domain.com.
Yeah, I even find it in my personal life when stuff gets a bit sort of disheveled in a lot of places. It's like, man, what are those fundamentals that you can just
the fundamentals, that's
into?
The key word, yes.
Do you find, because I noticed that you do a lot of like coaching and training and put a lot of value back in the industry, going out and visiting other agencies, do you find that that's something that people kind of overcomplicate things a little?
You mean in me talking to other agents?
Yeah, do you talk to other agents? Like, what are they? What are the questions they're asking you?
where's your business coming from? How are you closing the business? What prospecting do you do? Why do you do it? And that's really big right now. So I like doing that because I reckon I get as much out of it as they do, hopefully. Mm-hmm. Like us now, we talk about it. It's reminding me of things. I'm enjoying it. It's using another part of my brain, not just listing and selling real estate. So I do that because I think it's fun, man. And it helps, hopefully helps people as well. The questions are weird. Everyone asks different questions and wants to know different things. A lot of agents looking for like the magic pill.
Yep.
Like, what can I have that's going to get me these 10 deals every single month without doing anything? I'm still looking for it too. It doesn't happen. It doesn't exist, right?
Do you think we can afford as an industry to be a bit closer in that respect? Like, do you exclusively go to stone agencies? Or do you go
100%. Yes, I think you're right. Like, there's no... Even most of my competitors in our area, like, we're fierce, but we'll talk to each other. We can have a beer with each other, 90% of them. Yeah. So I try... I think that's just crap shit. Like, why be like that? Especially at the moment, I think since COVID, everyone's got a bit more... appreciative of each other and supportive of each other. So no, I don't mind if we can help someone out, whether they're in our agency or someone else, it's fine. It's helping someone. It's like, there's, if you study like psychology and that, if you're giving a hug, you're getting a hug. And if you're like helping someone, it's helping me underneath anyway. So I think it's fine.
Yeah. No, I've talked to a few people lately that are like, not that they're putting good stuff out there for the purpose of or expectation of getting stuff back in.
Yeah.
It seems like just... weird coincidental that
exactly,
good
Clay.
Shit comes back.
100%, you know? Man. There's no rule to it.
Yeah.
You do the right things. It's like, what do people say? Like, someone say you're really lucky, and it's like, yeah, but the interesting is the harder I work, the luckier I get. It's weird, right? It's like coincidental. But yeah, I think it's karma, isn't it, man? You do the right thing by people and it comes back.
Man, I want to go back to social.
Yeah.
Because, you said a great thing at the start about people looking for real humans.
Yeah.
Not just like the rock star real estate agent. And I think, like, I can see almost the way you're using social media and you're on Instagram. It just seems like you and, like, a self-expression of yourself. And, you know, it's got family. It's got pugs on it. It's got some cool toys and Bali trips. And
100%.
Was it strategic or is it just something that you just throw out there?
It's probably half-half. Like, I reckon, like, I follow heaps of agents. Don't know half of them. Half of them are my mates and, like, it's just boring, man. Like, fucking heaps of people just putting up, like, new listing, new sale. It's like, I just find it really boring. And that's just me. And then I'm like, are your sellers following you on Instagram or your buyers? Probably not. So, like, who gives a shit? Like, a lot of it's ego, trying to show off in front of other agents. Yeah. I found it really boring. Like, I've been limiting Instagram heaps lately.
Yeah.
I find a really interesting space where it can almost be depressive for some people because they're looking at lots of toys I can't have, why don't I have that, and then ages. Yeah, dude, it's not always real, I think, what's on there. And so, yeah, I just try and, if I use it, I've really calmed it down lately, but if I'm doing it, it's just me and what I'm kind of interested in. It's about my motorbikes and cars and a bit of travel, and there's a bit of real estate on there, so I'm still an agent, but it's not 100% real estate because I think 90% of people find it boring.
Yeah, well, you're not 100% real estate, so why would you put that out there?
I think it's trying to... maybe people are trying to create business from it, but I don't think you're going to get business from that. Like I do a bit on there, so if you're like you're in my network, and you might see it, and then if someone's selling in Man, they go, fuck it, it's always selling a lot. I'll pass one to Eddie, he's good. So you get a bit of that, but I think it's more about not just in social, but in everything, like relationship. And go, he's a good guy, he's normal, not just some agent that does a lot. That's how I feel at the moment about it. Funny space.
Man, I agree. It's becoming more and more obvious, I think, that aspect of it. I think there are still guys out there that very much use it as a business tool and go all in on it and kind of can do it well.
Yeah.
But I think the authenticity side of it's getting bigger. And in fact, I'm going to be talking to a guest next week, an agent that was going really hard on it and then kind of had that, like, that negative mental impact on them where they did just have to shut off because there are too many, I think, our industry and agents, we're always looking at each other and comparing each other. And
100%.
You're right, most of it's the kind of fluffy, all the good shit, but not the, you know. I look at you guys, man, it's tough. It's one of the most, you have to be the most resilient.
100%.
Right? You're punching 100%. The face all fucking
day. Yeah, all afternoon. It's terrific. I love it. No, there is that. And look, it's an interesting space. Like, it's all just comparing to each other and a lot of it's false. Not false, but it sets a certain perception as well, which can be right or not right. But it's, I don't know, like I don't, it's just an interesting thing. I love Instagram for like research right now. So I want to look at a toy or like if I want to look at I come into motorbikes and cars and watches and shit like this. Yeah. So I want to like look at a new one. You can't go into a shop and look at it, but you can watch videos in Europe and all this stuff, or somewhere to travel to. Like, I find that really cool. That's where I like it. Awesome. I'm not really scrolling through going, oh, blah, blah, I've done 8 sales this month. Oh, wow. Like, it's so, I think it's really boring, personally. Yeah. I think that's also with video, which is good. So I think video is really good still. And where I found it went weird for a while, like either you boys doing my videos and, you know, Christian's here, and when he rocks up, I say, just get the property, man. You get a little bit of me and that's it. And he knows that.
Yeah.
And I reckon there's like 80% of agents out there, and fucking half the video is on the agent in his sick new suit, like looking around and got my perfect tire. No one wants to see that, man. Like, if I don't know. I don't think. Yeah. It's just like a profiling tool. And
I agree.
I don't know.
We've been peeling it right back. And when we, Christian will tell you too, like, man, I'm trying to convince guys just to get out of it.
Yeah.
Like, our favorite videos are like, they might, if they want to do an intro, but do it as a normal human.
100%. Yeah, that's what I think is good. That's where we went to. We'll do an intro, check out the property, because this is a property video.
Yeah.
It's not half of a profile of an agent. So I think that's a funny place where it's gone as well. But that's doing the right thing for the client and the property, not getting them to pay for a video of you walking around in your new suit.
Yeah.
Be raw today. You're telling me to be raw, bro.
I know. I love it. I love it.
I hope so.
Speaking about, like, and I love the new toys and seeing that kind of stuff and the motorbikes and the cars and everything that you put up as well. And it's not like in a real egotistical kind of way either. It's just you appreciate something, which I don't think there's anything wrong with that. But I've always loved, from a marketing perspective and a brand building perspective, I think like prestige cars do it really well in terms of getting people hooked onto a brand.
Yeah.
Particularly things like, Porsche and Lamborghini and Ferrari.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
What are kind of things and that you think, like, because you have a nice Porsche, are there any sort of
brand? I need to talk about that. Cut that bit out.
It's located at this address.
Yes.
Like, are there brand aspects that Porsche do for clients that you think that maybe real estate or our industry could
be? Yeah. I think, okay, as a brand, like you're asking about it.
Yeah.
Difference I've found with that brand is it's not, how do you even say it? I suppose it's like a boutique.
Mm-hmm.
It still feels boutique, not mass produced, right? Because everything is full custom, every little stitch and everything on it is custom. It's not a Ferrari level because it's different. Again, it's not better, it's just different.
Yeah.
But yeah, I like Porsche. It still feels like it's smaller, it's intimate, it's more of a, I don't know how to explain it, but they have something, right? They kind of get you hooked. They've always had a saying, like, once you buy one, you'll never drive another car, which I don't know if that's right, but I see what they're saying at.
Yeah.
See, I don't know how to answer that, man, but there is something where it's expensive, like all the cars are expensive, but it definitely feels like it's a bit more boutique. It's still a bit more rare. They do what they do. Like, you look at the 911, it's like so old fashioned. It's like from the 60s and not much has changed, but it's them. They're like, I don't care. We're not changing
it's
it.
It's got their own character, their own personality.
Yeah, 100%, which is like people as well in our industry. Like, I'm really raw with clients in that, you know, there's not, we don't suit up much anymore. And it's not putting on this big show. It's just talking to them, being raw, or swearing in front of them and things because it's me. If they don't like me, that's fine. They go also, like friends or like a partner, you just be you. If they don't like you, well, fucking that's all right because this is me, you know, not this false side. And I feel that's like what coming back to brands, Porsche's done that. They're not changing anything, which I like. It's pretty cool. And
do you think that we are caring too much about what people are thinking about us?
That's
what
I don't know. It's hard, hey, dude. How do you get it right? Sometimes I think, fuck it. Like, if they're going to hate me, they hate me anyway. I'll just do me.
Yeah.
And I do it, and then the other time, like, oh, it's not even worth it, just delete it.
Yeah.
I don't know, it's hard to know, isn't it?
We do kind of overthink things a little bit, I think, on it as well.
Yeah, well, maybe spot on.
I've actually, so to kind of lock in some of my decision-making stuff, because I struggle with some of that too. I have my own set of, like, core values that I read pretty much every day to myself.
Yeah.
And one of them is, like, being the change I want to see in the world.
Yeah,
so
cool.
I reckon, like, it's gonna take kind of one person at a time doing what they feel is right.
Yeah.
Whether that's posting your own shit because you want to, or, you know, if I see you post some stuff, jumping on and going, yeah, man, that's awesome. Like, talking people up a bit more.
Yeah, not the opposite.
Yeah,
people
it seems like
the opposite.
You know, the same thing when you have any experience with a real estate agent or a buyer or a seller. It's like, you know, the people that have bad experiences or the negative stuff to say tend to amplify that a lot more than the positive.
Of course they do. Right? What is it? The rule is if you do something good by someone, they'll tell three people.
Yeah.
If you do something bad by someone, they'll tell 11 or something like that.
Yeah, it's probably more now, right?
Like, yeah, I reckon it is.
Everyone's got such a bigger spread of influence.
Yeah, exactly.
It's like, yeah, man, if you do the wrong stuff, and I think that's a lot of what social media is now. It's like spreading a bit of hatred and shit like that, and I think it's going to take people going, you know what, let's fight that with positivity, with love, with
positive, 100%. Easier said than done, but
totally,
right?
Yeah, but I think it starts with us, man.
Good.
And I think it's like, even when I went to the States last year, I was blown away by that. It's like, you know, someone tells you what you do, you know, what are you doing for them, what are you doing right now, what are you working on? You kind of tell them, and here you're sort of like a bit hesitant.
Yeah, because, I am. Super.
Yeah.
Stupid.
It's stupid. And then over there, someone's like, oh, that's awesome. Oh, I might know this guy. And they're like,
Send hook it up. 100%. Much better.
Are there any particular ways that you think maybe like things that we might change in the next sort of 6 months to a year in terms of kind of how we're doing things? Or you think it's going to be those fundamentals, build up relationships, help people through this time?
Yeah, I'd be what you said. Like, I think when we... I saw someone speak that owns a big company, and they're like, we're not doing face-to-face meetings, everything's Zoom, everything's this. And we're like, we're the opposite, man. That's me again. I don't know if it's right or wrong, but like when we went through COVID and like lockdown and stuff, me and Tim were in the office every single day, hustling, doing the deals, on the phones. We're the only ones that did the deals through that time, funnily enough. Everyone working at home did nothing. Interesting. Exactly, man. Yeah. But I feel like this next 6 to 12 months, for us, we're just back to basics, having the face-to-face meetings, doing the calls, meeting the clients, doing the hustle. Not, I think a lot of people get too, oh, we've got to have a new Zoom app.
And try something different.
Totally do. No, just do the basics. Yeah. Works. It's like the gym thing. You want to lose like 10 kilos? Yeah. No, there's no secrets. Like, do some exercise, eat better. That's it, man.
Repetition.
Don't read a 40-page book to try and find out how to do it. Yep. We know what to do. It's just doing it. It's not easy to do it, but it's doing it, right?
Yeah. I love it. Man, I think that's a great thing to end on. Just fucking do it.
Just fucking do it. Hustle and get it done. It's good, eh?
All right, bro. Thank you.
Thanks, brother. So good.
Pleasure.